There has been word from the capital. Ishgard has weathered another assault, and 'tis said several wyverns broke through into the city proper. The temple knights succeeded in slaying the beasts, but the intrusion prompted orders to further strengthen the guard and to place the city under a perpetual state of alert. How keenly we feel the loss of our wards at the gates of judgment. Yet we must not bemoan our misfortune. Sir Emeric is safely returned from Uldar, and once more leads the defense of Ishgard. As for the matter of your asylum, I am afraid no progress will be made until the threat to our nation is diminished. But do not despair. You are not without allies. You are more than welcome to shelter here for as long as you wish. Pray, think of it as a new headquarters of sorts, the Falling Snows, or some such. All frivolity aside, any who come here in search of you will receive no aid from House Fortong. For once, the Ishgardian reputation for inhospitality shall work in our favor. Agents of Uldar will find their every inquiry dismissed, and their every request for entry rebuffed, until such time as their masters have acknowledged your innocence. You once fought to preserve the honor of my dear friend. 'Tis a blessing that I may now repay that debt in kind. But let us dwell no more on this. Pray, join the rest of your companions. 'Tis bitterly cold this day. I suspect there are those who might welcome the warmth your presence brings.
'Tis all my doing. I believed myself the only one who truly understood Eorzea's woes, and look what that arrogance has wrought. I gave commands, influenced governments with my certainty. I treated the Crystal Braves, and even the Scions themselves, as pawns in my great scheme to save the realm. But in my headlong rush into imagined glory, I paid no heed to the ground upon which I trod. The salvation of Eorzea. What was it that I hoped to achieve? Did I believe that I could rid the realm of every danger and difficulty? That I could defeat the Empire and the Ascians, and find homes for every refugee? Oh, yes. I was so very clever. Become a guardian of Eorzea, I implored, and sat back to watch my perfect army cleanse the land of chaos. It was all but a means to feed my own vanity. Only when all is lost do I finally realize the truth.
Alfino.
So, Master Alfino, are you content to remain a broken blade? Is there no flame hot enough to reforge you? What of the fine companions who yet stand at your side? I dare say the fires of their determination will soon have you slicing the air again with your customary wit.
I hardly deserve such friendship. And besides, where are we to go?
Alfino, if I may? Should this place not serve our purpose, then we shall go to Ishgard. Minfilia told me many times, as long as we stand fast against despair, the beacon of hope will never be lost to sight. Be it in the snow or in the clouds, we few will see that the dawn's light shines again.
You are right, Totaru. Thank you. And thank you for your kind words, Lord Orshfon. 'Tis true that Eorzea yet has her guardians. The Scions have achieved much, and 'twould be remiss of me to discard it all in a fit of self-pity. Let us then resume our journey, together. One step at a time.
All has been arranged as you desired, my lord.
Thou thinkest sanctuary lieth beyond. Delusion. Despair. Death. Thou shalt find naught else here.
The dawn's light will shine again. So long as we have these specious accusations hanging over us, we will struggle to achieve anything. You must go to Ishgard, as Tataru proposed. I will return to Uldar and set things right.
Pray, do not be so hasty, Master Elfino.
Lord Orshifon.
Full well do I understand your desire to clear your names. But now is not the time for drastic action. You yet have allies upon whom you can rely. There is no need to act alone.
Yes. Yes, of course. Pray for...
I bring tidings. Count Edmont has decreed that the three of you be taken in as wards of House Fortan. Under our patronage, you shall be granted access to the city proper. Pray, consider our manor your new headquarters, from which you may gather information and plan how best to proceed. Needless to say, should any of your missing allies be found, as I am certain they shall, they will of course be welcome to join you there.
You are more than generous, my friend. On behalf of my fellows, I humbly accept your offer of hospitality.
The Count is a good man and just. He will treat you with the kindness and respect that a hero and dear friend deserves.
To Ishgard, then, together. There we shall carry on the Scion's legacy. There we shall begin anew.
And so they came, at a friend's behest. Heroes once celebrated as saviors of Eorzea, brought low through treachery, their names blackened with royal blood. With memories of the lost and dreams of redemption, with hope yet in their hearts, they came. To Ishgard, shining city on the mount, overlooking the dominion of Kurthus. A great and proud nation, devoted to Hlone the Fury, ruled by Thordin the Seventh, Archbishop of the Ishgardian Orthodox Church. The last bastion of the faith, her walls ever bristling with the sworn swords and spears of her four high houses. A land that after 1,000 years of war had forgotten what it was to be at peace. Through gates long closed, the Warrior of Light and his companions passed, entering at last a city whose history was written in blood. In the midst of the Dragonsong War they came, three weary travelers whose arrival would set in motion great change. Though none knew then how great.
Thank you.
My lord, I have returned with the Scions.
I hope your journey was not too taxing. I, Count Edmond de Fortomp, do bid you welcome. As wards of House Fortomp, you shall be afforded every courtesy. My home is your home.
My companions and I are deeply honored, Count Fortomp.
The honor is mine, Master Alfino. Consider it an expression of our gratitude for your service to Ishgard.
Forgive me, my lord, but are you not concerned? To accept foreign guests at such a juncture, especially ones with our reputation.
Do not worry yourself on my account. 'Tis true that Ishgard's first thought has ever been the war effort, hence the closing of our borders. Yet it is in troubled times most of all that men should seek allies, don't you? Granted, my decision will have raised eyebrows in the vault and in the halls of the other high houses. But so long as you continue with your altruistic endeavors, I doubt my honored peers will feel moved to voice their concerns.
Then there is naught to fear. Though our numbers are much reduced, we are no less determined to carry on our work.
Full glad am I to hear it. But before you return to your labors, why not take a tour of the city? You would do well, I think, to acquaint yourselves with your new surroundings. After all, you may be here for some time.